Guess Ireland is as lucky as they say.
Hey, Dr. Worth. Oh, you mean the sign I was telling you about?
Mm-hmm. The one that made you call your father and tell him to get Aiden to the hospital?
Yeah. It was more like a message, I guess.
From?
People I cared about.
Cared? Past tense. Like ghosts? Or...
I don't really know how to describe it. I didn't see anything, really.
So they weren't wearing night sheets? Sorry. I don't mean to make light.
Absolutely okay. Believe me, I know how crazy I sound. It's just that I swear, sometimes I can still feel her around.
Her?
My wife. It's like she's sitting right next to me or something.
You know, that doesn't sound crazy at all. And that's a powerful thing. It connects us in ways that cannot be broken.
You're, part of this whole thing, you know?
Me?
Yeah, you're another sign.
This I gotta hear.
Okay. Before my wife passed, she wrote me a letter. And the first thing it said was if I should leave you.
So she knew she was sick? Or she knew she was dying?
No. I mean, she knew she was in danger. But that's a whole other story. The point is that she was giving me instructions, okay? To go to Ireland, to a churchyard, or what's left of it, anyway. And dip a rosary in a well.
Okay, I'm still not really seeing how I fit into this.
The name of the place was St. Margaret's.
No.
Yeah. And she said that I was supposed to receive a message.
And you did.
Yeah. I mean, I didn't believe it at first. I thought my mind was playing tricks on me. But then when I got the warning about Aiden being sick, I immediately came home, only to find that he'd been treated by you. Saint Maggie.
Believe me, I ain't no saint.
It has to be more than a coincidence, don't you think?
So what are we talking about? Fate? Divine intervention?
I have no idea. I don't know.
You know, you don't really have to be religious to believe in miracles. And I see them every day. These kids come in here and they have virtually no chance. And somehow they turn it all around. Survive.
Well, I have a feeling you have something to do with that as well.
Maybe I'm willing them to push harder.
Yeah.
Maybe they're willing me to try. No. Either way, every time it just blows my mind.
To be honest with you, working with kids in this kind of environment day in and day out, I don't think I could do it.
I mean, some days it's bad. It's really bad. Amanda, those miracles make up for it.
Oh, it sounds like those kids are lucky to have you. I know Aiden was.
You know, working in kids has taught me a lot. First and foremost, never give up. Not on hope, and not on people.
Hey, man, welcome back.
How are you?
Oh, you know, I was just gonna ask you the same thing.
Ah, you're deflecting again.
Yes, I am.
I can do that. Well, I'm hanging in there. A little jet lag, but...
Good. Aiden, Elizabeth?
Oh. Aiden is a rock star. Seriously. I mean, it's like he's getting stronger every minute. It's incredible.
Good.
Elizabeth, on the other hand...
Wait, she had a setback?
No, not physically.
Yeah, well, she's been through a lot.
Yeah, I know. That's why, you know, I've been reassuring her and trying to keep her calm, and it's been working, because she's really happy right now that I'm back.
Maybe a little too happy?
Yeah, it's the same thing we talked about. I mean, Elizabeth wants to start over. I've explained it's not possible. How do I do this? Help me. How do I explain it again?
When she's staring up at you from a hospital bed with tubes.
Exactly.
I don't know. That sucks, man. I don't envy you.
That sucks. Yes. That's all you got.
That's all I got.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
I try, you know. I mean, Elizabeth wants somebody to save her from drowning. I like her faceless, but manly stranger on Spoon Island.
Any idea who that is?
Well, according to Dr. Hunter, She made the whole thing up as a way to cope with trauma.
You disagree?
Yeah, footprints don't lie. I mean, you know, wet ones. You know, when I was poking around Windermere the other day, right, and I found a trail inside the house.
So you think someone's there?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. And they cannot hide from me forever.
Okay, so if someone's there, okay, if this person really exists and he saved Elizabeth's life, then
why wouldn't he call for help when he rescued her? My thoughts exactly. You said you were jet lagged, so come on. Let's get you home and get some sleep.
Dude, I couldn't, even if I tried. Every time I close my eyes, I just hear a bunch of noise.
Yeah, those thoughts running wild through your head. Yeah. I've been there.
Any advice on how to make it stop?
Well,
I mean, that doesn't involve copious amounts of booze.
Then no. No, not really. Yeah, if it's any consolation, though, alcohol doesn't really help. It just kind of makes everything warm and fuzzy.
And it helps you fall asleep and forget about the nightmare for a while.
Mm. But then when you wake up, the nightmare's real as ever and you got a headache.
And that I remember.
Yeah. And speaking of nightmares, in Ireland, did you find that message from beyond or whatever you were looking for?
I sort of did. I think so.
Okay. Well, what was it?
Still trying to figure it out.
Okay. So now what?
Now what? I don't know. I mean, just take it a day at a time, focus on what I do have the power to control, like being a good dad, good cop. Is that
really?
Funny?
Really? Oh, wait, you're serious?
Yes, I'm serious.
Oh, God, come on. That can't be
okay.
Enough.
All right. Ethan, I'm going to tell you something. So just listen here. Okay. I may be a lot like Dad in many ways, but I do not need a jewel heist to get through the day.
Yeah, I don't believe you for a second.
Yeah, neither do I.
Look, it's not a bad thing to want something more out of your life.
Even if you have absolutely no clue as to what that is.
Oh, yeah. Look, mate, the mystery, that's all part of the fun.